Hey guys, so my name is Son of a Gap, and this is Back to the Future, the game. And we're back with the last episode of the series. Soon there will be a new Telltale game, and we will get right into it. Without further ado, here we go, episode 5, Out of Time. And as always, I will remind you guys, you have the possibility to vote for the next Telltale game. Just write into the comments, and at the moment there will be, there would be Game of Thrones. And if you don't want to see Game of Thrones next, if you want to see Batman next, just vote for it. And otherwise, we will take this. Alright, here we go. Starring Telltale Games. Back to the Future, the game. Episode 5, Out of Time. If you remember correctly, we broke up Emmett and Edna last time around. But the old Emmett got back together with Edna at the end of this episode. So let's see what we will have to do to get through this time.
Hello?
Marty! You're awake! Good!
Emmett, where are you?
I'm down at the expo. I snuck out early to avoid my pop. If he knew I was about to make a publicly scientific spectacle of myself, he'd hit the roof.
Okay.
Why didn't you wake me up?
I tried to give you a nudge before I left, but you were practically comatose. How long has it been since you slept?
Aside from being knocked unconscious, I'm not really
sure. Yeah, me neither.
Anyway, I left you back at the lab to perform an important mission. On the table next to my law books, there's a device plugged into the wall.
I think I see it.
Is it glowing?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, is that good?
Good? It's fantastic! Glowing means my static accumulator is charged up and ready for action. Bring it down to the
static accumulator?
Damn!
What?
It's Edna!
But...
Ah, goddammit.
Okay, Emmett. One static accumulator coming up. Yeah! Jeez, Doc. Watch out, you almost ran me over.
Sorry about that, Martin. This vehicle is sometimes difficult to control.
Yeah. Hey, are you okay? After that argument about Emmett last night...
I'm fine. Thank you for asking.
I don't think he's fine.
So, how are the time circuits?
Still broken. I've got a few ideas, but I'm occupied with other problems today.
Mm-hmm.
So is that what I'm destined to build for the expo?
Yeah, it's a static accumulator. Emmett spent all night building it. Turned out he didn't really need to see Frankenstein after all. He just needed a little push. And some lightning.
Fascinating. I also had an epiphany last night.
Yeah, he wants to sabotage.
Doc?
I realized that it wasn't Edna that made my life miserable.
Doc!
It was science!
You can't give up science. You love science.
Correction. My younger self loves science. But if Emmett doesn't go through with a demonstration at the expo, his dreams of being a scientist will dim just enough for Edna to step back into his life and steer him down another path.
What?
Another path? What other path?
I don't know. Architecture, automobile repair, taxidermy. Maybe I'll even pursue a life in law like my father always wanted. As long as Emmett steers clear of science, Edna and I will be free to be happy together.
Oh, come on.
You can't want Emmett back with Edna. She used you to turn Hill Valley into a police state.
She used my science to turn Hill Valley into a police state. But if I don't become a scientist, she'll never get the chance to vent her crazier ambitions.
Doc, I'm begging you. You haven't thought this through.
Haven't I? I guess we'll both find out. One thing's for sure. Emmett Brown's life will be a whole lot less complicated without a time machine in it.
No! What the hell?
Where'd it go? Yeah, that's a good question. Oh, there it is.
Oh, come on. Here, little static thingy.
Why is it floating? Can I climb this post? Yeah, I can.
Gotcha!
Uh-oh. Okay. Ah, that's the expo.
The future is coming today. There's a shiny new tomorrow on the way. A day of invention is at hand. It's a mystic, futuristic wonderland. Just around the bend, my friend, you'll see a dream or two.
Enlightenment under the sea.
Your dreams can all come true. There's a world of wonders.
Professor Fringle's algae cakes.
Not bad, eh? Not bad at all, but I thought you fired her. I found a loophole.
Okay.
What kind of loophole? Just a loophole. You're not the only one who's allowed to have secrets, you know.
All right.
Say, don't you have to get that whatchamacallit to Emmett Brown's booth?
Huh? Oh, yeah, right.
Because the future is coming. It's almost here now. The future is coming. It's getting clear now, the future is coming today.
Okay. Alright, where do we go from here? Glass house. Future furnishings for a push button world? Why is Edna here?
And here he comes, right on cue. No doubt he'll try to talk you out of it, Detective, but you mustn't let your resolution waver.
Hello, Corleone.
What's she doing here?
Well, Miss Strickland here seems to think,
You should step aside and let the officer do his duty, now.
Huh? What do you mean? What are you doing?
Wait a minute, that's Emmett's levitator up there.
Oh.
Oh, don't be so modest. I'd say you deserve at least half the credit. It was you who tricked poor Emmett into breaking up with me. It was you who manipulated him into dropping my project in favor of this clear hazard to public safety.
It was my plan to get him back to inventing what he should be inventing. What's your point?
Oh, I think you know exactly what my point is. Emmett's invention isn't going to work, is it? At least not the way poor Emmett thinks it is.
How do you know
this? Yeah, how do you know this?
I had a very interesting chat with Carl Sagan last night. I found out who Michael Corleone really is, and where he comes from.
Is there something you want to tell me, Michael?
Why don't you call him by his real name?
What?
Yakov Smirnov.
What?
Thanks a lot, Doc.
An anarchist! A foreign agitator bent on sowing chaos and destruction in the Hill Valley Expo!
Annie, you don't believe any of this bullshit, do you?
Sorry, Yakov, but I really don't have a choice.
Very good. And now, arrest this subversive!
What? No.
Look, here's the thing. I happen to believe this dame's got a screw loose, but she's been getting some clout in town ever since that business with Kid Tannen.
But Emmett's gotta fly that electrokinetic levitator at this demo. His whole future depends on it.
And my future depends on making sure he doesn't. The chief reads her column religiously. Well, if I don't do what she says, she's gonna start a campaign to have certain tainted officers removed from the force.
God damn it.
Isn't there anything I can do?
Not unless you've got some dirt on Edna. Something that'll discredit her in the eyes of the law. Well?
I'll dig something up.
You do that. In the meantime, you and young Mr. Brown better... Where is he anyway?
I don't know.
Wait, you haven't seen him?
Emmett? Has this foreign radical done something to my Emmett?
Maybe you should find him.
Oh, you're letting him go? This radical subversive? Just like that?
Okay, so, I gotta find Emmett. And do something about
Oh yeah,
Emmett.
Definitely. She's really pissing me off. Okay, let's talk to the first person we see. Who is it? Ah, this is, Trixie. Let's talk to her.
Hi, Trixie.
That's Technie to you, Technie. Kiddo.
Right. Congratulations on getting the old job back.
Thanks. Justice triumphs in the end, you know? Now, what can I do you for?
Well, let's start at the top.
So, which exhibits do you recommend?
The most popular attractions are the glass house, the future furnishings, and of course, Enlightenment under the sea. You know who that is under the diving helmet? That's Jacques Dutot himself.
Never heard of him.
Of course, you need to get tickets if you want to see the main attractions.
Okay.
How much are tickets?
Aw, put your money away. Here, you're kind of like family now, you know?
Oh, thank you.
Thanks.
Okay. Do you know where Emmett is?
Have you seen Emmett around? I'm kind of worried that he's not at his booth.
Let me think. Yeah. He wandered down that way a little while ago. He was talking real intense with another guy.
Older guy? Looked a lot like Emmett in the face?
Yeah. Uncle or something?
Aw, Doc.
Or something.
Damn it.
Look, Emmett's demonstration has hit a snag or two. Can you delay his act for a while? Let someone else go before him?
Sorry, I don't set the roster, and they won't let me change it. I can drag my feet a little, but if your friend's not ready to go on pretty soon, we might have to skip his act. I mean, demonstration.
But you can't!
Hey, it's just a science demo. It ain't a matter of life
well,
and death.
Well, actually, it kinda is.
What time is Emmett supposed to go on?
Let's see, 8 kilobits past 50.
What?
We're on metric time here at the Hill Valley Expo.
That doesn't make any sense. 8 metric times out of 50? What?
Edna Strickland is trying to get Emmett's booth shut down.
That dame don't know how to mind her own business, does she?
Do you have something against her?
Is there anything you can do to get Emmett's booth open again?
I wish there was, but I'm just a muse. All we can do is inspire people.
Okay, you're a muse. Can you inspire me an idea?
I'll try. Well?
Maybe it doesn't take effect right away. Artie told me how you managed to get your old job back.
He did? But it was supposed to be a secret.
There's no secrets between us. He couldn't resist telling such a good story.
Yeah?
Still, I'd like to hear it again, from your point of view.
He didn't tell you anything.
Come on, Trixie. I'm dying to know how you got the job back.
You won't hear it from me. I don't talk out of turn.
Okay.
Thanks.
Happy to help.
That's it for here. I won't talk to those guys. Who else can we talk to? Oh, that's new. Never seen that when I hold R2. I was trying to run, but running is with circle. Okay.
Enlightenment awaits you under the sea.
Okay.
Excuse me, Mr.
Dutot, Jacques Dutot, at your service.
Oh, yeah.
I'm looking for a friend of mine, Emmett Brown. Tall young guy, reddish brown hair.
A distracted look.
That's him. Any idea where he went?
He just passed by here with an older gentleman. I think they were added into the House of Glass.
Into the House of Glass. Thanks. Okay, let's go there. House of Glass. Wasn't it over here? Oh, there they are.
Hey, Emmett, come out of there. Don't listen to him.
You can't hear him. What the hell?
Perfect.
That's not looking good. Not at all. Glass house. Let's get in here.
Welcome to the Atlas House of Glass, the future of domestic life.
Okay, Emmett, let's get you out of here. Emmett! Emmett, don't listen to him. He's crazy.
I'm still not sure about this business proposal, Mr.
Why can't you hear him?
Let me explain it again.
Is it a glass?
Atlas glass.
Ah, okay.
Unbreakable and
that's what I thought.
Soundproof glass. Mm-hmm. Great.
Our living space can be configured to meet the needs of any family. Need a private study? Simply slide the walls in, or slide them out again to create a spacious banquet.
That's actually pretty cool. Can we? Okay, let's just do that. Let's see what we find behind wall number one. Okay, another handle. Is it just... Really? Okay, this is a dead end. That's not moving? Huh? How am I supposed to... Oh, maybe this way? Okay, that's not the way to go. Okay, I think I'm stuck here. That's wrong again. Maybe this will work now. Nope. Does not.
Something's blocking it.
Something is blocking it. This blue wall. But how can I move this blue wall? Okay, let's go back to the beginning. That doesn't help me when I move that. Doesn't help me at all. Wait, oh, that's the exit, okay. Okay, now then he's just moving out. I think I'm missing something here. Oh! Wait. The green one, we have to get rid of that. Wait. How do we do that? Oh, I can't. Or can I? And now I can. Okay. Very good. Oh no, he's going to sleep. Oh, I knew it. Oh god damn it, no, I was there before. This is like a maze. I can't move this. Okay, the red wall is blocking it. Wait. Red wall. Through here. Okay. who would build something like that? Where did they go? Okay.
Emmett? Where'd you take him now, Doc?
Greetings again, mortals! This is Techni, Muse of Progress. Hoping you're all having a swell time taking in all the exhibits. Don't forget, you can purchase tickets to our main attractions right here at the information booth.
Oh, okay. Okay, let's find them. Oh, wait. Let's talk to him. Maybe he has seen them. Diver.
Excuse me, sir. I'm looking for a tall, thin, older gentleman. He might have been with a tall, thin, younger gentleman.
I know just who you're talking about. Hey, just
wait, that's Doc voice.
About a minute ago. If you hurry, you might catch them.
That's Emmett.
I know you're in there, Doc.
Yeah.
Doc? Yes, I am a doctor of marine biology, but I fail to understand what you're...
Quit fooling around, Doc. What have you done with
him? Stop! Help! I'm being attacked!
Michael! What are you doing? You can't assault the exhibitors!
He's not an exhibitor.
You don't understand. He's kidnapped Emmett.
The boy's obviously confused.
I'll say he is.
You want I should toss him out on his ear?
That won't be necessary. Do you know who that is? That's Jacques Duteau of the Oceanic Institute.
No, it's not.
No, it's not. It's...
Please keep it down. The Expo went through a lot of trouble and expense to secure Professor Duteau. We can't afford to antagonize him.
But...
If you've got a complaint against him, we can straighten it out after the show. But if you make another scene like that, I'm afraid I'm gonna have you expelled from the hall.
Damn it.
Where'd you stash Emmett? In the diving bell?
It's called a bathysphere.
Aha! So Emmett is in the bathysphere.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Professor Duteau, huh?
At your service.
Hmm. Take off your helmet.
I prefer to leave it on. The inland air is difficult on my sinuses.
Okay.
I think I'm gonna take a closer look at that bathysphere.
I got some tickets, so...
Not without a ticket, I'm afraid, sir.
Hey! Is this guy trying to bum a free ride?
Actually, I do have tickets.
No.
See that you don't. Feels good to be on the right side of the law.
What have you done with the real Professor Duteau?
I'm not sure I like your insinuations.
I'm not sure I like you kidnapping Emmett.
Perhaps I should call the authorities and have you removed from the hall.
You're a cold-blooded guy, Duteau.
C'est la vie.
Take a ride in a bathysphere. Your bathysphere. I'd like to see the inside of it.
Can't get in without a ticket, I'm afraid.
You're not gonna get away with this, you know.
As they say in my country, que sera, sera.
I do have a ticket. Wait. Let me in. I have a ticket. Here.
Here's my ticket. I want to see inside that bathysphere.
I don't think so.
What?
What do you mean? I've got a ticket. You have to honor my ticket.
It's the wrong kind of ticket. Sorry.
Oh, give me a break.
Okay. Can you help me?
How about an algae cake?
Sure thing, mister.
Wait a minute. You're the guy that makes the algae cakes? But I thought you couldn't stand them.
Hey! You're the guy that tried to pick up on my Eunice!
For the love of...
No algae cakes for you, Buster!
Okay, he's not helping me? Come on, Grandpa.
Hey, Artie,
what do you think? Quite a setup, huh?
The Expo? Sure, but I was wondering.
Yes.
This ticket should get me into any exhibit on the floor, right?
Sure, that's a pee ticket.
Well, the guy at the aquarium is refusing to honor it.
There must be some mistake. Come on, let's straighten this out. Professor Duteau, this young man claims you refuse to take his ticket.
Not at all. I am only too happy to take his ticket. Please, climb the ladder, and I will raise the bathysphere.
Okay. Let's see, Emmett has to be in there.
Mon Dieu, what is the matter? The gears, they must have become
stuck. Yeah, of course.
I am afraid I cannot raise the bathysphere at this moment.
What a shame.
Yes, it is. Well, I will work on the problem. Perhaps if you come back later.
Are you joking?
Come down, please. The bathysphere exhibit is currently closed for repairs.
What does that do?
Step back! You're crimping the hose!
Okay.
What does it matter if there's nobody in the bathysphere?
It's very bad form.
Oh, sorry.
Next up on our roster,
ah,
the man who saw the possibilities in pond scum. Welcome, Ernest Philpot!
It's an old nautical superstition. A crimp pond speech. Imminent doom.
Hey! You ready to drop the act now, Jacques Duteau, a.k.a. Carl Sagan, a.k.a.
No!
Emmett gets no air until you raise the bathysphere.
Emmett? Who?
Emmett, you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just gonna keep holding this air tube closed until you raise the bathysphere.
I wish you wouldn't.
Why not? There's nobody in the bathysphere, right?
Come on, drop the act.
You ready to drop the act now, Jacques Duteau, a.k.a. Carl Sagan, a.k.a.
No!
Emmett gets no air until you raise the bathysphere.
Come on, do it. Just do it.
Emmett? Who?
Emmett, you. I'm just gonna keep holding this air tube closed until you raise the bathysphere.
I wish you wouldn't.
Why not? There's nobody in the bathysphere, right? You know what happens when the air runs out. To both of you.
What else can I do?
The hose!
Raise the bathysphere, Doc.
Maybe you should just wait.
I command you, uncrimp that hose!
Thank you, Ernest. Do be sure to drop by his booth and sample an algae cake. I have, and it was very interesting. I will be back later to highlight another of our fine exhibitors. See you soon!
I demand you uncrimp that hose!
I demand you let Emmett out of that bathysphere.
I don't know what you're...
Hey!
Come on.
I'm just gonna keep holding this air tube closed until you raise the bathysphere.
I wish you wouldn't.
Why not? There's nobody in the bathysphere, right? You know what happens when the air runs out, to both of you.
I command you uncrimp that hose!
I demand you let Emmett out of that bathysphere.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay.
Step off the hose!
Yes, do something.
Raise the bathysphere, Doc.
I won't do it!
Then neither will I.
Oh! Ah, he's doing it.
So the lords, the gears, they have become
unstuck. All of a sudden.
There, see? It was just a malfunction after all.
There he is.
Let's get you out of there.
Finally.
Emmett!
it was true.
Of course it was.
Hey, you.
Hey, he just took that guy's wallet. I think he took his wallet.
Oh, remind me not to become an oceanographer. I guess I must have a touch of claustrophobia. Never should have gone.
Mm-hmm. Well, we've all got problems. Now, you'd better get back to your booth.
Funny
before...
thing is, I don't even remember going in there. Last thing I recall, I was in the glass house talking to Carl Sagan. Did you know he's really a scientist?
I'd heard. What did he say to you?
Oh, he had some sort of spur-of-the-moment business proposition. It was all very rush-rush. I never got the details. It would have meant leaving before the expo was over, so I told him that... Say, where'd he go? You know?
Carl Sagan? He had to leave. One of his experiments blew up.
No, I know how that is. What's this?
Oh, yeah. Edna made Detective Parker shut down your booth. He says he can't go against her.
Oh, yeah?
Unless we dig up some dirt that'll discredit her in the eyes of the law.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what we'll do.
The question is just how? How are we gonna do that? This is a clock. This is not working. Let's just take a look around. Maybe we can find something.
Welcome to the world of tomorrow, where a man's home is truly his castle. Here, gratification is just always a push of a button away.
Okay, I want to see what this is all about. I think we got some time. Okay, let's start with the red button. Fruit-bearing helicopters. This sounds very expensive.
Ah, oh, it's wax.
Okay. What happens if I hit... okay. Fruit basket, green button.
In the house of the future, phone conversations will be completed in the privacy of the personal phone helmet.
Hey!
Please recite the phone number you wish to dial. Or say, hang up, to terminate your phone helmet experience.
Okay.
Klondike 4385.
Brown.
It works!
Hey,
cool.
Hampton, how's it hanging? This is Marty, Emmett's friend. I just wanted to chat with you for a while.
Conversation terminated.
Aw.
That was rude.
Okay, what else? Blue button.
Chinese checkers and everything.
That's it? That's all? Okay, this was the place we came out of. I don't want to go inside again. The console. Potted plant? What can I do with that?
This plant doesn't belong here. There's nothing futuristic about it.
Okay.
The next exhibitor on our list is Officer Danny Parker of the Hill Valley Police Force. Officer Parker is going to demonstrate a few of the many marvelous tools that our boys in blue will soon have at their disposal. The criminal element has truly met his match today. Officer Parker?
He's still talking.
It seems our next exhibitor is unavoidably detained, but I'm sure his presentation would have been both enlightening and exciting. How about a round of applause just for the heck of it?
Okay. Interesting. What else do we have? Phone booth of the future.
Welcome to the phone booth of the future, made with Atlas glass. Atlas, unbreakable and soundproof. Our phone is hands-free, so you can enjoy a sandwich or a cigarette while chatting with friends in perfect privacy. Would you like to place a call?
Yes, I'd like to talk to...
Unfortunately, this phone booth only accepts incoming calls.
I just wanted to say, if you're smoking in that in such a small room, I think you would get dizzy pretty... 4253? Why was he looking at that? Wait, I'll write it down. He was looking at that. I think that has something to do with anything. 4253KL. Okay. Yeah, I think you would get dizzy in such a small room when you're smoking in it.
Greetings, forward thinkers of Hill Valley.
Oh, there's another plant.
A potted plant? What's this got to do with law enforcement?
That's a good question.
A potted plant?
Ooh.
What's this got to do with law enforcement?
It's cool.
No, a plant. But it's got a wire recorder hidden inside, see? If we could have got one of these into Tannen's speakeasy, and if he's the kind of guy who talks to plants, we could have busted him a lot earlier.
Oh, maybe we can... Wait, can we switch it? Can we take this one? Maybe we can record Edna with something, and then we got some dirt on her.
What?
Just the question is where to put the plant. What's this, a futuristic weapon?
Oh.
The electro-pacifier.
Amazing, isn't it? They say one day we'll be able to stun fleeing criminals by shocking them at a distance.
Does it work?
Nah, it's just a model.
You wanna stay away from those
now,
guys?
Can you please leave me alone to do my
What's
job?
This?
In a minute, I'm not quite through yet.
Are you ready for a picture radio? Wonder if that's anything like MTV.
Yeah, it is. At least like a TV Trixie.
Hiya, folks.
Can you help me?
Hi, Trixie.
Now, what can I do you for?
No.
Thanks.
This is just for incoming calls. Can I do something else here?
Would you like to place a call?
Yes, I'd like to talk to...
Unfortunately, this phone booth only accepts incoming calls.
I'm stuck. Now you've got a bug, but where to plant it? Yeah, that's what I'm thinking about. Your mark will only talk freely if she believes she's got perfect privacy. So the phone booth. Can we put it here? Yes!
Okay. Call me a snoop.
Now I know. And then we will call the phone. And she's near. I need a phone somewhere. To get her talking. Just how? There are no cell phones here. Now you've got the receiving end all set up where to place the call. Yeah. The one with the future will be equipped. Yes, there is! Ah, I forgot that. Okay. I just was there and totally forgot about this one.
Welcome to the world of tomorrow, where a man's home is truly his castle. Here, gratification is just always a push of a button away.
Okay, so we have to use the console. Fruits. Phone.
In the house of the future, phone conversations will be completed in the privacy of the personal phone helmet.
Please recite the phone number you wish to dial.
Oh, I know.
Hang up to terminate your phone helmet experience.
KL4253. Okay, I didn't have to remember that.
Klondike 4253.
KL stands for Klondike, okay.
Valley Expo, where the future is coming today. This is Checkney News of Progress. To whom am I speaking?
Oh yeah, let's pretend we are Carl Sagan.
This is Carl Sagan.
Ooh, the mysterious Mr. Sagan. What do you want?
Talk to Edna.
Can you put Edna Strickland on the phone for me?
Sure thing, Mr. Sagan. Hey, Strickland! Somebody actually wants to talk to you!
Mr. Sagan, what happened? I thought you were distracting Emmett.
I was? Oh, yes, of course I was.
Then why is Emmett standing here, valiantly trying to convince Detective Parker that he should be allowed to go through with this ever-so-dangerous display of wrong-headed technology?
What can I say? I was outsmarted by that wily Yakov Smirnoff.
Well, that puts a crimp in our plan.
Which was?
Yes, our plan. About that plan. Regarding, you know what?
You know what?
The little matter we were whispering about yesterday.
Oh, that? As a matter of fact, I'm glad you brought it up. I was thinking, wouldn't it be a good idea to pin it all on Yakov Smirnov?
What?
Pin what on him, exactly?
You know, it!
Come on, what is it?
Oh, I get it. You're still sore about going to jail. That was the dog's fault. If he hadn't come glumping up to me right after I started the fire, I could have gotten clean away, and I never would have had to divert suspicion to you.
Jesus.
He's the speakeasy arsonist.
Oh.
Carl, is somebody with you?
No, it's just you and me. You know, I don't think I ever asked you why you burned down all those speakeasies.
Why? Because no one else was doing anything about them. Every night they'd open up their doors serving illegal drinks and loose women, flaunting their depravity to the world, and the authorities did nothing. So I did what any right-thinking, rock-willed woman would do. I took action. Oh, and such a gorgeous action it was, too. The fires were so beautiful. The alcohol made them go up in such pretty blue flames.
She's a criminal.
Where was I?
You were explaining why you burned down the speakeasies.
Yes. Did you find my answer to your liking?
It was very revealing.
Oh, yeah.
Hang up.
What?
Conversation terminated.
Jeez, Edna was always a loon. I hope that confession's good enough for Parker.
Yeah, I think so, too. I really think so. Okay, let's get the...
Hiya, folks! It's me, Techni, Muse of Progress, gracing you once again with my presence. And speaking of presence, what better gift could Hill Valley offer the world than this magnificent science and technology exhibit, hey, folks? If you haven't done so already, I urge each and every one of you to take a peek at Furnishings of the Future, right here in our main hall. Tickets are available from me, Techni, at our information desk.
I didn't even know she has a desk. She's just standing around there. Ah, there's a desk, yeah. It has information, of course. Okay, let's take the plant. Let's go to Parker. And then Edna is...
You know, I don't think I ever asked you why you burned down all those speakeasies.
I think a lot of people are going to be interested in that answer.
Then we should be good to go.
Oh, no. Hello, Smirnov.
Hey, Danny.
Do you mind, comrade?
Comrade?
Why is he trying to keep Emmett from letting you lead him into the biggest mistake of his life?
Mistake? My biggest mistake was...
This'll only take a minute.
Our plant recorder.
It's not a good idea to steal police property, you know.
Shh. Listen.
You know, I don't think I ever asked you why you burned down all those speakeasies.
Why? Because no one else was doing anything about them.
Edna? You're the arsonist?
Detective Parker, surely you're not going to believe this crudely manufactured forgery of a recording.
I'm not sure what to believe, ma'am. But based on this crudely manufactured forgery, I'm afraid I'm going to ask you to come down to the station to answer a few questions about your whereabouts on the night of the speakeasy fires.
Emmett?
You're on your own. Darling.
Oh, very well. Heavens, what's that?
Sneaky.
You know, one of these days I should really stop calling for that.
Yeah.
Not to sound callous, but does this mean I can demonstrate my invention?
Let's take that as a yes.
Greetings. Finally. Salutations to all our honored guests. I am Techni, Muse of Progress. And it is my pleasant task once again to highlight one of the great minds who was hard at work building a better tomorrow.
I think that's me. I'm next on the roster.
But are you ready?
No, I don't have a choice. Did you bring the static accumulator?
Oh, right. Here you go.
Great. Come on, let's get up there.
And who knows? One of this kid's gizmos just might take off and change the life of everybody in town. Could it be the very thing he's brought to share with us today?
That ought to do it. Are the block bearings all in the raised position?
What?
Block bearings. Ray, Terry's position. Check.
Then it looks like all systems are gone.
Cool.
Wish me luck.
I don't have to.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Emmett Brown.
Objection!
Oh, no.
Objection, Your Honor. I hereby demand that the scientific demonstration of Von Emmett Lethra Brown be terminated and forfeit by reason of insanity. I declare
his father
him to be in contempt of me, his father. Where is he? Hand him over this instant.
Where did he come from? All of a sudden.
You can't hide from justice.
Nah.
Okay.
I don't think so.
What? What am I supposed to do? Because of the flower still in my hand. Okay, let's talk to him.
You don't think you can shelter him?
Yeah, be reasonable.
Maybe Emmett would come out from wherever it is he's hiding if you tried the reasonable approach.
This is the reasonable approach.
Don't antagonize him.
Well, if you're not gonna say anything.
So he is up there with you.
Thanks a lot.
Son, I order you to come down from there this second. I want to speak to my son.
Emmett's not ready to talk to you directly.
Oh, God. I suppose you're his mouthpiece.
What, he's German?
I guess so, yeah.
I didn't know that. Let's take that.
If I can say so, sir, the problem is you're coming on too strong. You intimidate him.
I don't intimidate him enough. That's the problem.
Can't you two have it out later?
You mean after he's gone through with this ridiculous stunt?
Yeah.
No!
But actually, we Germans, we don't roll the R like that. So this...
You can't talk him out of it. His mind is made up.
So, if talking won't work, there's always threshing.
Okay, I can't talk to him anymore. That's...
Stay right there.
I'm not going anywhere.
What?
Fear!
Come on, Emmett.
Emmett.
I'm not talking to him. There's no point.
Maybe he'll give you a fair chance to explain yourself. He is a judge, after all.
Yeah.
Yes, a judge who's already passed sentence. He won't listen to me. He never has.
I'll be right back.
Wait, really? Okay.
So, is your client prepared to make a statement?
He says he won't listen.
He says it's no use talking to you. You never listen?
That only shows how pig-headed he is. Of course I listen. If he can justify his craziness, I'll be only too happy to indulge it.
Stay right there.
Are you kidding? I have to talk to them back and forth? Okay.
Emmett.
I'm not talking to him. There's no point.
He promised he'd listen to you.
You heard him. He said he'll listen to you.
Well...
At least give it a shot.
Great, now they're talking. Okay.
Father,
here we go.
Son?
You've never understood the first thing about me. All you want to do is step on me, squelch my natural instincts.
Understand.
You don't know what it's like
Let's
to be young.
Understand.
You don't know what it's
You're
like to have dreams, to have ambitions.
Big overgrown baby.
So powerful
scratched
that they've got a life
you.
Of their
I
own.
You
and it's all you can do to hang on for dear life while they gallop on where they must.
Don't
this
it
is America,
you,
Pop. And in America,
age,
a person doesn't have to do what his father did. Isn't that why you came to America? To live where there wouldn't be so many rules?
What the hell was that?
Oh, we talked. Are you happy?
Well, not really.
Please, you gotta get out of Emmett's way.
I have yet to hear a compelling or even coherent reason why.
Can I give him one? It's important to him.
See, Your Honor, it's just that this demo is so important to Emmett.
A childish kerfuffle. He'll forget all about it in 2 weeks' time.
I don't think so.
That's what I'm afraid of. Emmett's just...
stubborn, willful, single-minded, incorrigible, and obsessed.
Okay, but if you look at it from the right angle, those traits are kinda...
Yeah, they can be.
That may be your angle, Sonny, but I'm not so sure it's the right one. Make no mistake, those are traits that lead to trouble. He gets them from his mother.
Look, Your Honor, you don't see it, but there's an awful lot riding on Emmett's demonstration.
All the more reason why I've got to put a stop.
Why?
Look me in the eyes, young man. I expect you know my son pretty well by now. Do you seriously think his exhibition is going to be a success?
Yes.
Sure. Sure it will.
Ha! You know as well as I how it'll end. Disaster!
Maybe, maybe not, but even if it does, I mean, isn't Emmett entitled to make a few mistakes?
Mm-hmm. Emmett has exceeded his quota for one lifetime. It's my job as his father to see to it there are no more mistakes.
Emmett's just trying to make a name for himself. Maybe things were different when you were a kid, but nowadays you gotta take chances.
Mm-hmm. What do you know about taking chances? Try moving to a strange country where you don't speak the language with only $2 to your name.
You?
You bet your socks, me! And I made out all right, too.
How'd your dad feel about it at the time?
Papa? He was fit to be tied. He called me a disobedient little...
Nah?
So your father didn't approve of you coming to America?
Correct.
Well, Papa never really understood the younger generation. He came around a bit in the end, but by then it was too late to.
See?
Tell him I'll listen to him. I want to listen to him. If he wants to talk.
Finally. Okay. Emmett?
Here to play peacemaker again, Pollyanna?
Pollyanna? Why Pollyanna? It must be impossible, but it's not. His bark is worse than his bite. He only yells because he loves you. He says you're like your mother. Yeah. Let's go with that.
He says you get your stubbornness from your mother.
Well, that's the limit. He's not satisfied with insulting me. He's got to drag my mother through the dirt, too. Mother isn't at all like me. She's gentle and sweet and endlessly patient.
Aww.
If anything, I'm more like...
Like a dad?
You were starting to say that you're like...
Skip it.
Can it be that you and your dad?
No. Next subject.
Emmett, stop being a dope. Yep. You've got your pride, okay, I get it. And so does he, but what's the harm in trying to make peace with the guy? He's your family, and family's important. Sometimes it's, well, even more important than we realize. Mm-hmm.
May I come up?
Come on, guys.
So, you think my new invention is a disaster waiting to happen?
Yes, yes I do. And I am here to say... If any son of mine is going to make of himself a public disaster, I insist on being there to support him.
Oh.
Pop. You're gonna change your tune once you see this baby go airborne. You see, the force field generated by the static accumulator... Marty, give Trixie the signal. We're ready for liftoff.
Yes! Finally.
Oh, good. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for bearing with us through that unavoidable delay. And now the Hill Valley Expo is pleased as punch to present Mr. Emmett Brown and his electrokinetic levitator.
Okay. Here we go. Come on. This will work. This has to work. Yes!
Look at that! He's flying! My Emmett is flying!
So cool. I think it would break down, right? Ah, not those two again. No. Who is this? No, Edna's in the time machine.
You okay?
Are you kidding?
I thought I could change her.
Things could be. You're a fool.
Forget about it. Come on. We gotta find a way to stop her.
Before she reads. Don't come any closer.
88.
Doc.
Go away!
But...
Move! Marty!
Great. That's what we want.
Oh my god, Doc! Say something.
Chromium, lithium, potassium, iridium, titanium, ruthenium.
Okay, I'll get help.
Do I have to remember that?
Newspaper.
Newspaper?
What? You mean...
Key to the city?
Gonna get you to a hospital, Doc. You're gonna be okay.
Yes. Oh, I think I am going to be okay.
What's going to happen?
Oh, come on, Doc. Doc, don't do this. Don't go.
Oh, shit.
Doc, come back. Doc?
No, it's just Emmett.
Marty, have you been out here the whole time?
Emmett? Is it over already?
Oh, it's over, all right. You missed a very wild party. I'm afraid I've been banned from the expo for the next 50
what?
Years. And if I were you, I wouldn't go back in either. At least not until all the broken glass is swept up. Oh, what was I thinking?
Oh.
Naturally, the ionic wind generated by an electromagnet of that size is going to play havoc with a merely mechanical steering mechanism. We need a much more advanced control system. I wonder if we could find a way to translate the
body's
gravitational field into electrokinetic force. One might be able to direct the ionic current simply by shifting one's weight. Oh, great Scott, that's it!
Mm-mm.
So, what comes next?
Work, work, and more work. A few more stumbles, followed by a breakthrough or two. The way I see it, it's those little mistakes along the way that advance us along the pathway of knowledge. Come on, there's no time to lose. Let's get back to the lab and... I'm sorry. Is something wrong?
It's a long story. Let's just say I lost somebody.
Oh, how sad. Anyone I know?
No, nobody here knew him. He was a complete stranger to this world.
I know the feeling. Sounds like a man after my own heart. Then it is someone I know.
Yeah, no, forget it. It's got nothing to do with you. What?
You're a complete mystery to me, Marty. Where you come from, what you're doing here. But there's one thing I do know. Whatever it is, it does have something to do with me.
Please, Emmett, don't ask
What's
any...
What's this? Come on, let me see. I deserve an explanation.
I don't think so.
You wouldn't understand.
Oh, yeah? Try me.
Oh, really? He's showing him the newspaper?
What's that?
An explanation. But you've got to promise me. Don't look at it until you get the key to the city.
Huh?
Just promise.
Emmett, where are you, my son?
I'll be right there, Pop. Key to the city? I don't understand.
And you can't understand. Not for a long time. It would do irreparable damage to something. Just say you promise.
Okay, I promise.
Okay, how are we supposed to fix this?
Wait. I will see you again, right?
I guarantee it.
Edna. What did you do? What the hell did you do? Is it pink?
Yeah, it worked.
Oh! It's not Edna.
So, you were the same Marty. Funny how memory can play tricks on a person. I remembered you being much taller.
At least he came back.
How was the ceremony?
Long. You've got a theatrical way of sending messages.
Only way I could do it without messing up your timeline.
Very clever. But what are you doing in 1931?
That's a long story. Yeah.
I came to make sure you stayed on the path of science.
As opposed to what? The dog food business?
Politics.
Politics? That doesn't sound like me.
It wasn't.
Never mind. It's better I don't know. Let's just get back to 1986. That is, unless your presence has caused any other time anomalies.
I'm not sure
me?
Yet.
Nah, no. Well, I'm still a little confused about my...
Who's this?
Where is he? Where is that no good son of mine? He's not worthy of the McFly name.
What? Marty?
You see my Artie anywhere? Artie McFly? That's the one. Just got a call from Melvin at the city records office. He tells me the dad blamed Fool's gun and got himself hitched to a Canadian floozy. Can you believe it?
What is he talking about?
Hitched? Married. I swear, that boy's gonna put his papa in an early grave. So that's how she got her job back.
That's not good.
Ah, he's married the wrong grandma. Yeah. I mean, Trixie's not my grandma. And if she's not my grandma, I'm not me. Wait, that was great-grandpa Willie. I met him when he was a baby. He peed on me. Holy crap, Doc, I'm gonna disappear again.
Calm down, Marty. You seem reasonably solid right now. Whatever the problem is, I'm sure we can undo it with the help of...
That car!
Aww.
Great.
How the hell did she get back here?
She?
She?
He means
you.
Edna.
You're not Edna. What's going on here? Is this some plot to put me in the nut house?
No, it's all very simple.
Well, actually, it's
oh,
not.
I'm sure
it's
it
not
is.
Simple.
Tell me. Did I or did I not just chase Edna Strickland off in this car?
Not this exact car, but a car just like it.
A car with a nasty habit of disappearing into thin
oh,
air?
Oh, shit.
Well...
Wait, Edna Strickland just disappeared in the DeLorean?
If that's what you call it, it made a loud noise, and then wham! Nothing!
Oh, shit.
Great Scott! Marty, do you have any notion what date she might have jumped to?
None at all, Doc. See, that DeLorean's time circuits are out of whack. They could jump to any date at all.
Oh, this is bad. This is very bad.
Mm-hmm.
Let's just hope she jumped into the future. The far future. If she's jumped into the past...
You think she might mess up the time stream? Wait a minute. This is Edna. Of course she would mess up the time stream.
Mm-hmm.
Guys,
that evil
you
witch.
Mind telling me what the hell you're...
What happens now? He's gone.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. The whole town is gone. What the hell?
Doc?
That...
Did we just leave Hill Valley?
No, I believe Hill Valley just left us.
How?
Something must have happened to it. A long time ago.
This is Willie again? Haysville.
Well, now you two look a mite lost. Hey, what on earth is that thing?
Oh, it's an experimental vehicle. Pay it no mind.
Look, maybe you can help us. Did your son just marry a Canadian saloon singer named Trixie?
Artie? Pshaw, that boy ain't got nerve to ask a girl to the church social. You acquainted with him?
Only slightly.
Oh, we're just passing through, we hope.
Yeah.
Tell us. We're looking for Hill Valley.
Well, which is it, a hill or a valley?
No, it's a town. It's a town called Hill Valley.
Hill Valley a town? Say, I think I once heard that there was a town here a long time ago. Don't know much about it, though.
Just as I suspected. Shit.
When did Hill Valley go away?
Oh, heck, I don't know. That was all before I was
born. Wow.
Then whatever it was must have happened at least 45 years ago.
Nobody much cares to settle around here nowadays. My dad tried to buy a farm in this area years ago, but he got run off by Scary Mary.
Scary Mary?
Scary Mary.
Well, that's what we all call her. Lives a couple miles from here. I make a monthly drop at her place. She's a fiend for news. Takes all the papers in the county, never throws one away.
Etna.
See, if there's anybody who can tell you what happened to Hill Valley, it's her.
That's
Can you
Etna.
Direct this to her?
It's imperative that we talk to her.
Sorry, fellas, but I'm pretty sure she won't talk to you.
Why?
Why wouldn't she talk to us?
The thing of it is, guys, Mary's older than dirt, but she's also a little touched, if you catch my drift. She doesn't like strangers.
I'm sure we can have...
We are no strangers
we'll
to her.
Be very polite, please. We gotta see her.
Well, okay, if you insist. Take a right turn just after the bridge, then follow the wheel ruts till they come to an end. You'll have to go the last quarter mile on foot. Good luck, and don't say I didn't warn you.
Okay.
I got a notion I'll be kicking myself for sending you up there.
This is now really messed up. We have to stop her.
Can I drive?
You're kidding.
Mary Pickford.
Wipe your feet. Okay. No solicitors. Stop. Go away. I will just go into the house. Mop. Outhouse window. Saloon sign. Let's get in there. What? I didn't see that. I didn't see that. Yeah, that's Edna, right.
Pardon us for intruding, madam. We were wondering if you could tell us...
I don't talk to hooligans!
Not a very friendly sort.
Doc, that was Edna.
Edna Strickland? Impossible.
This is how she was when I first met her. I had to... Listen, just leave it to
me.
Okay, you think you know how to handle her. Just remember, we need to know what happened to Hill Valley, and just as importantly, the precise time when it happened.
Okay. Wait, this is the DeLorean. This is a burnt out car. Oh, goddammit. Tripwire. Tripwire. We have to set this in motion once more. Those are all pieces from the DeLorean.
Hey, Miss Strick.
Who are you?
She doesn't know me. She knows me as Yakov.
Yakov Smirnov?
That's a foolish name! And I make it a rule not to talk to strangers with foolish
names!
Okay,
maybe it was wrong.
But we're not strangers!
How do I know you?
I saved your life once, a long time ago, remember? Kid Tannen had you tied up.
Listen, Sonny, I'm an easygoing woman, but I got a few rules I live by. And rule number one is, I never... Never talk about the past! Or the future, neither. I don't talk about any day but today.
Are you kidding?
I guess that didn't go so well.
Of course she doesn't talk about the past, because there's something in her past she's trying to forget. But we're gonna pry it out of her. Go ahead, knock on the door again.
Well, I didn't even knock on the door. Here you go.
What?
It's me again, your old friend.
How do I know you?
We spent a day together?
We spent the day together.
We did? Where?
At the expo.
That's crazy. I've been here all... What day is it?
Tuesday, October 13th, 1931.
October 13th, 1931. October 13th. Something funny about that date. Well, what are you here for?
I brought something.
I brought something for you.
What is it? Let me see.
What do I have for her? The tickets? I don't think that I can use those tickets. Duck.
I brought you him.
Him? Ho him. Him ho.
Emmett Brown.
Look hard. Don't tell me you don't recognize your own boyfriend.
My boyfriend?
Yeah, he's all grown up.
Come closer, fella.
Marty, what am I supposed to do?
Trust me, Doc. Just go with it.
It can't be. Emmett.
Yes, Edna. It's me.
It is. It's October 13th, 1931. Oh, and you are Emmett. Emmett. How did I get so turned around? Have I been dreaming? Well, stay there.
It's a classic case of repressed memory syndrome. Once the mental dam is broken, the subject is immediately plunged into the midst of the very scenes she's trying to forget.
Okay. Never heard of that. Oh my god. That doesn't help at all.
Darling, you've come back. Of course I knew you would. An intelligent boy like you wouldn't be one to throw away true love all because of a silly quarrel. I've already forgotten about last night's little tiff. I trust you've done the same.
What?
Of course I have.
Last night?
Of course I have. What?
Sweet stuff? Schnookums? Baby face? I don't know. What did he call her? Let's say sweet stuff?
Sweet stuff.
Sweet stuff.
You've never called me that.
Damn it!
Something's wrong here.
Schnookums?
Schnookums.
Schnookums.
Oh, you're sweet.
I don't
but
even know what that word means.
You're company with this Smirnoff character. I insist you drop him. He's a bad influence. And you've got to stop working on that dangerous electrokinetic... What's this?
Okay.
I suppose now you're miffed with me for forcing Detective Parker to close your booth down. Bitter medicine for you, I know, but I had to do it. And Parker had no choice but to obey my orders. He knows that my opinion carries a lot of weight in Hill Valley, and he'd never... Parker would never... Oh...
What is it?
I don't know. Something about Detective Parker. Something that happened to me on October 13th. What could it be?
Did she really forget that she used the car to get back in time?
If we can keep her mind in the past, we may get the full story of Hill Valley's premature destruction.
Okay. Okay, I think I... How? Edna's trying to remember a traumatic incident initiated by Officer Parker. You know what that is, right? Edna needs a good visceral reminder of the moment when she stood exposed as the speakeasy. Oh yeah. Okay, I need something to Wait. Let's take a look around. Maybe we find some stuff to disguise ourselves as Parker, and this will jog her memory.
Yeah, I can wait.
Okay. A mop?
I'm guessing this mop doesn't get much use.
Okay. I don't know what the mop is for.
I wonder what's cooking.
What's this? Oh, it's a windshield wiper. Burning stick? Do I need that for something? I can't do anything. Doc, Edna, clay oven, outhouse.
What? Upset her, Marty.
I guess this isn't the right time to be burning things.
I have to burn something? Okay. What do we have? Burned out DeLorean. No.
I hate to see it like this.
Yeah, me too. Mailbox?
Mary Pickford. Now where would she pick up a fake name like that?
Blacksmith sign.
A blacksmith sign? I wonder if it's from Doc's old shop.
He puts it in his pocket. Okay. Okay, there's nothing else here. Wait. Cactus.
Help me out here, Danny.
Don't talk to him. I won't have you spreading stories about me.
But wait, she thinks this is Danny? What else do we have? Her hat.
This hat doesn't frame her face very well.
Okay, tripwire, Edna, window.
Edna's grandfather, Marshall Strickland. That's the same picture I saw in Edna's apartment, way back, in the future.
Okay, that's not helping me at all.
An old saloon sign. Cool. Too bad it's all burnt.
Okay, let's take a look. I need some hints. Play Edna's confession back to her. Okay. So she thought this is... the cactus is Danny. She thought this is a person, so she has bad vision. Can we put the hat on that? Hey, cool.
Nice fit.
Maybe even that? And now it looks like a hair, okay. Saloon? The saloon... on the outhouse? Okay, now she thinks this is the saloon. What else do we have? The blacksmith sign. We got that as well. We can just show her that.
Speakeasies.
Why? Because no one else was doing anything about them.
No! Turn it off, you imbecile! If Parker hears that, he'll... Officer, I can explain. It was a trick. I was framed. Oh! He's after me!
Okay.
Ha! He'll never catch me in this souped-up car of the future! I can't shake him. Well, no use in holding back now. Let's see what this baby can do. And... he
what comes?
I don't know. Something really unexpected is supposed to happen right about now, but I'm not sure what. Oh, come to think of it, how can I be expecting something unexpected?
The noise is missing.
Quick, Marty. We've got to find a way to push the story along before she snaps out of her reverie.
We need noise. The noise when the DeLorean hits 88 and is going to the future or the past or the time, whatever. Tripwire.
Maybe not.
Not? I was pretty sure I need the noise. Ah, I still got the flower, okay.
Here they come! The lights!
Yes!
I'm being transported!
Where?
Back! Back! To the past!
What do you see?
Hill Valley! But it's all different. It's so small and primitive. Heavens! Can it be? It is!
Is what?
Grandfather! Big as life!
Marshal James Strickland came to Hill Valley in 1869, shot by...
I know, Doc. We met him in 1885. Remember?
No!
I don't.
I must be mistaken. Grandfather didn't look like that. That man is an imposter! I'm not even sure it is a man! This is all very confusing. Where am I? Why am I thinking about the past? Get off my lawn, you kids!
Better find a way to bring back Marshal Strickland, quick! We've got to bring this story to a climax!
Oh, Grandfather! How well you look! How well everything looks!
How does everything look? Tell me!
It's a bit rustic, to be sure, but all the buildings are so sturdy and well-kept, and the young people of Hill Valley... They're so virtuous and upright. So unlike the degenerate specimens from the 20th century. And I know the reason why.
Why?
Why?
They haven't yet fallen prey to the vices of booze and debauchery. They are still in a state of innocence. I think I could learn to like living here. But who's this?
Who?
This big lout swaggering up the street. Lips curled in an insolent sneer.
The speakeasy.
He's a newcomer to Hill Valley.
Or not?
Beauregard.
Tannen?
Yes!
Good guess.
Look at him. Acting like a big shot. Throwing his money around. Stolen money, no doubt. Why can't they see through him? The two-bit phony! And now his plan becomes clear. He's bought a plot of land in town.
Yes.
He's going to put up
a speakeasy.
A what?
I don't know. It's something I don't like.
And then she
something
burned it.
Evil. A saloon? In Hill Valley? Oh, he can't do that. Grandpa, you can't let him do it. You can't let that snake ruin paradise. If they're all too blind to stop him, I'll just have to take the law into my own hands.
Yeah.
I'll make sure this sinful establishment never opens its doors. I don't know what I'll do, but I'll do something. Something very conclusive.
And this is where we build the place. Now I know. Okay.
You're doing it all wrong. You'll never burn like that. First, we'll need some kerosene.
Okay.
Apply it liberally to the building site. No sense in being parsimonious. And now, watch.
That's how she burned it.
Isn't it beautiful? The devil's handiwork consumed by the fires of righteousness! Burn, you sucker! Burn!
She was none of this passionate when we were dating.
Oh.
What is it, Edna? Is it the fire?
Turn away! Don't look!
It's not staying in the saloon, is it? It's spreading to the other buildings in Hill Valley.
Ah, okay.
My intentions were pure. It wasn't supposed to happen like this.
But it did happen like this. And you've been repressing it all these years because you can't stand to admit that you're...
A criminal. Yeah.
I'm a hooligan.
Oh, God.
Did I lay it on too thick?
Here's the story. Black and white and red all over.
Okay. What year?
Destroyed by fire. Started approximately 2 a.m. July 17th, 1876.
Of course, I'm not the real criminal in this story, am I, Mr. Sagan?
Where did
you
she get the...
You set me up for a fall. You and Shmernoff. You made me steal your infernal car. You made me burn down Hill Valley. And now, by the powers invested in me by the town of Hill Valley, I hereby sentence you two criminals to... You! How much have you heard?
Enough for a month's worth of headlines in a Hayesville Herald. 2 months worth if you shoot those fellas.
I could shoot you too, you know.
But you won't, because that would be against the law. And you never break the law, right? This is your cue to skedaddle. Right.
Skedaddle. Okay. Monday, July 17, 1876. So now we're even further in the past.
There's Beauregard Tannen's half-finished saloon. Sometime during the next hour, Edna's going to light it on fire and accidentally burn down Hill Valley.
I wonder where her DeLorean is.
We'll find it later. Right now, we've got to stop that fire.
Wait. Just a second. So it means she burned down the speakeasy in 1931, and when she got back in time, she burned it in a saloon in 1876. Okay, she really is a criminal. And it just repeated herself.
Come back, you go through the front.
Got it.
Saloon sign is here. Beauregard Tannen? Oh no, I don't want to wake him. Window? Shh. Quiet! Oh, she's already on your... Oh, no.
Who's there?
Edna, stop. It's just me.
Mr. Sagan, what are you doing here?
I was gonna ask you the same question, Miss Pickford.
Isn't
oh yeah, there
obvious?
He is.
I'm putting an end to your den of iniquity before it starts.
I don't think so, Mary. I don't like shooting women, but no one comes between Beauregard B. Tannen and his livelihood.
Tannen, stop! If you shoot, she'll drop the torch and this whole place will burn up.
So is he the father of Kit Tannen?
He'll shoot us.
Looks like we're at something of a standoff here, Mr. Tannen.
I don't see a way out unless somebody manages to disarm both of you at the same time.
Oh God!
How the hell am I supposed to do that?
That's a good question. Techie painting, Beauregard shotgun, loose floor, boot, shotgun, chandelier, dark, kerosene torch. What the hell? I have no idea what to do. Let's just... Can we leave? Pickle juice.
That ought to be handy for putting out torches.
Mm-hmm.
It's too heavy to lift.
Can I just... No, I didn't want to go there. Go back. I wasn't finished. Barrels.
I wonder what's in these. Oh, stop. Quiet. God.
What the hell? Oh, cow crap. There goes all my pickled pig's feet.
Damn it.
Why
Let's
are
go.
You dressed like that?
I wasn't planning on visiting the 19th.
Okay, let's put... Okay. We put... Take those bags. Put them on there. On the pallet. This will raise the other pilot on the outside. We will get the barrel up. So we can put out her fire. One more? Maybe it's... three? Magic number? No.
Mary Pickford?
Don't tell me that you're not traveling through time under a pseudonym, Mr. Carl Sagan.
Quit yammering, you two! Nothing worse than a chatty...
Crap!
Oh, damn it! I needed that. It's right over his
head, but I can't knock him out while Edna's still holding that torch.
Okay.
Going down.
Okay, this works. But
looks
I have
like
to
your torch is getting a little dim there, Miss Pickford.
It's still hot enough to bring down this little bit of Gamora, Tannen.
Oh, there's another one. Take this one. Now fix it. Put it on the pallet. Then you can leave.
All right, physics.
Cool.
What kind of odds?
Let's get up again. Ah, swing it. Nice. Stop it, stop it, no! Okay.
What was that noise?
What noise? I didn't hear a noise.
I can't do that yet. I need to... Okay, I need to move this barrel along.
Say, that's a lovely chandelier.
Just how? Not the painting. Loose floorboard. Oh! Good job!
Okay, that was lucky.
Won't be long now.
We'll just
they didn't see
it.
That? Okay, let's get back up. Ladder. Now we have somehow to set this all in motion. Can I just take that and maybe this will... Wait, where is it? Stand back.
Come on.
Got any last words?
I'll see you in hell, Tannen.
You first, lady.
Come on, you son
Come
of
on,
a...
grab it.
Ha!
Frog. Nice!
Who the hell are you?
I'm the diversion, butthead.
Bam!
Nice one, Doc!
Don't tell Clara. She thinks Fisticuffs set a bad example for the boys. Now, where's Edna?
Doc, she's gone!
Oh, not again.
We've got to stop her before she hits 88 miles per hour! Come on!
Alright.
Okay, Edna, nothing to be worried about. You're a smart woman with a strong moral compass. You just need to think your way out of it. Oh, fudge!
Okay.
What's she doing?
I think she's spouting euphemisms at us. Luckily, the road out of Hill Valley is still pretty rough in 1875. It's unlikely she'll manage to accelerate 88 miles an hour anytime soon.
How are we gonna stop her?
Good question. We can't risk injuring her or damaging the vehicle for fear of altering the timeline even further. Luckily, those diagnostic lights my alternate self put all over her DeLorean have given me an idea. Here, take these.
What are these?
Flux signalization modules.
How do they work?
I generally use them for maintenance purposes, but we might be able to use them to sync up with the alternate DeLorean's diagnostic modules, thus making it possible to link both sets of time circuits and override the time destination of the alternate DeLorean. At least that's the theory, anyway.
That's a great plan.
I didn't understand
all,
squat.
We won't need well the modules to the frame. We just snap them over the diagnostic lights.
Wait a minute, Doc. You want me to go out there? How the heck am I supposed to do that?
Good question. Let me think. Aha!
I know what he's doing. Oh no.
Hoverboard.
Oh, cool!
We've saved our hides a few times before, so it seemed like the appropriate tool to bring along for the job.
Sweet!
That's really sweet. I would love to have one. Okay, so.
You okay?
No.
It's just like riding a bike.
You ready to make the jump?
No.
Ready, Doc.
No, I'm not.
One, two, three, jump!
Whoa.
Nice form, buddy. How's the reception on the wireless?
Great. Where'd you get these?
From Burns Cash of 21st Century Video Game Consoles. Now remember, all you've got to do is attach the flux sync modules to those diagnostic lights.
Will do, Doc.
Flux emitter? This one?
Is this the starboard flux emitter?
Yes. Now plug in the flux sink.
Plug in the flux sink. Is this... You mean this one, right? Okay.
Nicely done. Now, aim the sink toward the receiving dish.
I'll try, but it's getting a little bumpy out here.
What now?
I already put a flux override here.
Okay, remove that. Oh. I think that's fine. Wait. Okay, we got that.
Great, that's one flux sink down. Two to go.
Okay. Let's go back to the front. Passenger door.
It's locked!
Okay. Front bumper. Windshield wiper? Can we climb over the hood? Okay, maybe not. Let's go again to the front. Front bumper, come on.
Whoa!
What the hell? Okay, then let's go the other way around. Rear bumper.
Don't cross through those flames, they may be radioactive.
Even like crossing through normal flames.
What? No, once again.
Don't cross through those flames, they may be radioactive.
I don't even like crossing through normal flames.
Can we close it with that? Mr. Fusion. Yes!
Nice.
Okay, now let's get back.
Not sure what that...
Put it away. Okay, let's get the other side. Driver side. Okay, there's a second flux emitter at the front. There we go.
Made it.
Excellent. Now let's get that flux override module on before she starts making life difficult.
Mm-hmm.
She's been making it easy up till now. Is that the port flux emitter?
Yes. Now plug in the flux sink.
Okay, we know how that works. We take this, put
here
it on that.
Nothing, Doc. Whoa.
Perfect. Now aim the flux sink towards the receiving dish on my DeLorean.
Receiving dish. Check.
Yeah. Put it away. Get on that. Get that. Oh. Easy. Come on. Okay, that works.
We're almost home, Marty. Just one flux sink left.
Get off my car, you hooligan!
You are the hooligan, girl. Driver door. Let's open that. It's not working.
Locked.
Damn it. Come Can't I just talk to her to stop the car? You lost, girl. Oh yeah, I can talk to her.
Edna!
What?
Let me in!
You want in? Fine!
Great. And now what?
Are you alright?
Not really.
What?
Pull over!
No!
Great.
Excellent, Marty. Now that you're on top of the board and into the task of fluxing to the overhead flux emitter.
That's great, Doc.
Oh, yeah, there's another one.
Ha! Nicely done! Now,
okay, actually, I wanted to get inside the car. Oh. Come on. There we go.
That's it! Get out of there, Marty!
So, what now? Just leave, come on. Jump on your board and leave.
Now what?
Now we take control of that destroyer with the flux synchronizers and... That's strange.
What?
What?
According to these readings, the temporal cohesion of Edna's DeLorean is decaying at an alarming rate.
English, Doc.
We've got to get Edna home, now.
Ah, that's why she was stuck in the timeline.
Hold on!
Okay, what just happened? Where are we? Or better, when are we? Ah.
Parker? Then I must be back in... Would you be kind enough to tell me what day it is?
It's the day I place you under arrest for arson, resisting arrest, and being a general all-round pain in the ass.
Great job, cop.
You can't arrest me. Not now, I just got back from the last century.
Would you look at that? Edna Strickland, drunk as a skunk.
I'm not drunk, you reprobate. I'm a time traveler.
Sure you are. I'm loving this.
I'll prove it to you. Come with me. We can do the whole day over if you want. We can fix everything.
We can start by drying you out. Come on, into the station with you.
You can bunk with me, doll.
I'd rather die. Stop it. Unhand me, you dolt.
Well, I guess that's it for Edna.
Yes, I suppose it is.
Is it done now? Are we done?
You know,
whoever
said time heals all wounds didn't know squat about time travel.
What do we do about that, DeLorean?
No need to do a thing. Ever since we synced up the time circuits, the temporal breakdown in Edna's DeLorean has accelerated at an exponential rate. By my calculations, the timeline should catch up with it in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now!
What the hell?
Cool.
Hey, Parker, you're not gonna believe this.
See? What did I say? Ready to go home?
Wait,
oh, yeah.
The timeline's not fixed yet. Look.
It's not? Oh, yeah, yeah. They shouldn't get married. They shouldn't.
Michael, you missed all the fireworks at the expo.
Yeah, so I heard. Listen, I heard a rumor about you two.
I guess we gotta come clean. Ta-da! Party took me to Reno last night.
Trying to keep a secret in Hill Valley.
Well, you gonna congratulate us or what?
No.
Then it's true. My grandpa's married the wrong grandma. I'm done for.
Hey, are you feeling all right, kid? You don't look so hot.
Trixie, you can't marry Artie.
Is this about my past with Kid? 'Cause Artie ain't holding that against me.
That's right, darling. The past is the past. Yeah, but... This just isn't right.
Now, I know marrying a Canadian for a work permit isn't strictly by the book, but hey, sometimes you gotta go out on a limb for the ones you love.
Isn't he just the sweetest?
Can you see through me?
Nope, never could figure you out. I thought you'd be thrilled for us.
You don't understand. You're supposed to marry Sylvia Miskin.
But I did marry Sylvia Miskin.
What?
What?
You didn't think my real name was Trixie Trotta, did ya?
Don't feel too bad. It was kind of a surprise to me, too.
Wait a minute. You're Grandma Sylvie?
Grandma? Hey, how old do you think I am, kiddo?
But you're so... so skinny and blonde and... Oh my god. I've seen you naked. You're Sylvia?
You okay, pal?
Yeah, I'm fine. Great. You kids go off and have yourself a wonderful honeymoon. And don't worry about your dad, Artie. I'm sure he'll come around. Come around to what? To approving your marriage. You seem kind of mad about it back at the high school.
Well, that was before I got a look at her. Besides, as my dear old father Seamus used to say, no sense in getting riled up over something I can't do nothing about. And honestly, now that I met her, I can't imagine a better daughter-in-law than the charming Miss Sylvie here.
Aww, thank you, Dad.
As for you, stranger, I'll thank you to not go poking your nose in McFly family business.
It's been a pleasure, Agent Corleone.
See you in the funny papers, Mikey.
Goodbye, Grandma.
Oh, this is so cool.
No, I took some pictures of Trixie in 1931.
Hey, that's my grandma you're talking about.
Okay, now I really think we've done it. The timeline is restored. We're back home.
Here we are, back in good old 1986.
May 14th?
15th. Best to build in a little lag time. Gives you a chance to catch up.
Oh, really? It's just
like the estate sale is still going on. Hey, okay. Don't you want to stay, Doc? You gotta stop the bank from selling off all your old stuff.
What are you talking about? Estate sale? Bank? I'm not dead, Marty. Clara and I are having a little garage sale, that's all.
Garage sale? You mean...
Marty, you're back from your trip. Hello, Doc. Selling off the family treasures, eh?
Not quite, but I hope you find something you like.
Speaking of which, did you find what you were looking for?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I sure did.
Great. Seems like everything worked out.
Is that
out.
A box of Asimov?
Let me get this straight. Are you telling me you live here now? In 1986?
Well, naturally. Claire and I maintain a part-time residence here. Wasn't that the case when you left?
No, no. Not exactly.
Strange. I can't imagine not sticking around. After all, I've got my late father's foundation to supervise. If I wasn't here, who'd present the annual Earhart Brown Scholarship for Young Scientists? Something funny?
Yeah.
I'll explain it to you later.
I don't see what's so funny about looking after a family legacy. Oh, almost forgot. I've got something for you.
What is it? Okay, it's not the correct timeline, not 100% correct, but a little
Happy
bit better.
Graduation.
What?
Graduation? But that's not for another. The McFlys of Hill Valley.
An exhaustively detailed history of your family, from your great-great-grandfather Seamus to the present.
Cool.
You traveled through time to write this?
Well, most of the research was done traditionally, but your grandma Sylvia proved to be something of a mystery.
Which is why you traveled back to 1931 to look for her.
Okay. Exactly.
Who knew she was singing in a speakeasy under a stage name?
This is great, Doc.
This is really cool.
It's the least I can do for the man who saved me from making the worst mistake of my life.
Yoo-hoo! Dr. Brown!
Edna.
Edna?
Oh, no.
Einstein!
What's going on? What are you doing with my dog?
The same thing I do every afternoon, silly man. Giving him such much needed exercise.
What?
Isn't that right, Einstein?
What?
Hey, Dollface, it's past time for our 3:30.
What?
Coming, sweetie. Oh, Mr. McFly, have you seen my stepson anywhere?
Oh, Biff, I think you're late for an appointment.
Oh,
what the hell?
Look, gosh, you're right, Mr. McFly.
Edna and Tana?
Oh, hi, Marty.
And she likes dogs now?
Don't they make a great little family? You'd never know they met in prison.
Yeah, yeah. I say.
Don't say anything. Let's just walk quietly in the lab. And there are no more surprises.
Yeah, really. I really hope. Well, at least she's not bitter and alone and living with cats. What just happened? Who's that?
Doc!
Marty!
What are you doing here?
You gotta come with me. Back to the future.
Marty, you can't be here. If your younger self sees you, the consequences could be catastrophic.
My younger self? Oh, right! Bring him along, too. This concerns all of us.
What
do you mean? Does something happen to us?
Do we turn into assholes or something?
Nah, we're fine. But our great-great-grandkids? What the hell?
Great Scott.
Oh, no.
Doc, you gotta come back with me. Back
Don't
to
listen
the...
to him, Doc. It's me you gotta help. If you want to save Jennifer and our 12 kids.
What?
That timeline was overridden 5 jumps back.
Doc. How can there be 2 more of me here?
I have no idea. My all rights of space-time continuum should be tearing apart like a cheap dish rag right now.
It already is. What my evil twin and I are trying to say is the future is totally jacked up, and you gotta come with me to save it. No, me!
And there's another one.
So, we meet at last.
What?
You altered my timeline once too often.
What's going on, Doc?
Well, we do seem to have a conundrum on our hands, or 3.
Yeah, Doc, but which one is the real me?
Isn't it obvious, Marty?
The one with the glasses.
Come on!
Prepare to be erased.
Doc, wait! What about the space-time continuum?
Yeah, what about my future? And mine?
The future can wait. We've got a present to catch up with.
Huh? I don't get it.
Where to, Doc?
Mr. McFly, thrill me.
Okay. I really thought there would be something else, but that was Back to the Future, the game. Alright. This was fun. But I don't know what to make of the end, so we'll just leave it like that, I think. Alright. I just take a cut here, and I want to say... thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this one. And there's still the chance to vote for the next game. There's Batman and Game of Thrones. And you can just write into the comments or here in the chat which one you want to see first. At the moment, it will be Game of Thrones. And I would start tomorrow. I'm still a little baffled about the game. yeah. And it was really different in comparison to the other Telltale games. Just because it wasn't as much as decide what you are doing and change the future, it was more like repairing the future and the past, and more like point and click and more puzzles. It's still a lot of fun. Now I would like to see a second game, a second Back to the Future game. Ah, it's just too bad. Too bad we will never see it. Okay, I will shut up now, and let's just listen to the music. Yeah, what I have to say, I'm really happy they used the original voices. Because I love the movies, and oh yeah, I would love it to be continued. But it won't be. But this this stream will be continued, or at least this tribute, like I said, tomorrow. And if you want to see more, just hit the follow button. And you will get a notification when I'm back online. And like I said, it looks like the next game will be Game of Thrones. And just as a little heads up, I have never played the Game of Thrones games yet. Just because I was never interested in. And because I haven't even seen the series yet. So, the TV series. And yeah, those would be first for me too. Yeah. Okay, once again, guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And I will see you guys later. Bye-bye.